What is up, guys? Miluk here, and today we are back in action playing some Arkmon. It's going to be freaking amazing. If you guys enjoy, make sure to go and click the like button. I'd really appreciate it, and it'd help me out tremendously. So, the video is probably going to be a little later today because I've been spending the last 3 or 4 hours doing this. So, I decided let's do the base on the outside. Also, we got a lot of name suggestions. We'll get to that here in a second. But yeah, I decided to do the base on the outside. So, I started off with this. I wanted to be kind of even with the cave entrance here. So this is going straight across, and then we have this guy right here. So I decided the size of the base. It's actually a lot smaller than what I originally planned, but that's just because, like, I'm a solo person, and making an absolute massive base is kind of impossible unless I just spend like 50 hours gathering and crafting resources. Yes, we have started. The size of the walls here is actually 16 by 16. So we have a 16 by 16 base. The outside here is 20 by 20. I'm probably going to make the outside a little bit bigger. Then we'll have like some walls or maybe just some landing pads where we can land maybe the flyers or just keep some of the other dinosaurs. Also, we could put some of our plant stuff out there, that kind of thing. What I want to do is I want to work on the base a little bit. I want to make some vaults and start storing some stuff. I've actually destroyed a lot of the old base over there and got a lot of the resources. Not everything is emptied out yet. That took me a while to actually destroy and empty out a lot of stuff, but I've emptied out quite a bit of it. And we're going to try to make some vaults and things like that. So the first thing we want to make is we want to make all the smithies. So let's just go ahead and look at the smithies. So we need to make a normal smithy, a glass metal smithy, and then we might as well make a gate smithy too. So let me go ahead and make all these guys. Boom. And I guess we will just do this right there and then that right there. I'm going to stick the smithies down here. We want to make sure they're decently in the center. So I'm going to do just the normal smithy like right there. Here, I guess. Sure. Boom. We're going to put the glass smithy, I guess, like right here. I figured the bottom could just be just the smithies. That seems to make the most sense to me. And then we're going to put this guy like right there. Boom. So we have the smithy. We have the glass metal smithy, which is to make all this stuff. I went and crafted a bunch of things over there before I destroyed stuff. And then we have the gate smithy, which we actually haven't messed with yet. But this has all the gate stuff. Actually, I kind of like that they made a smithy because it makes it easier to keep everything kind of organized instead of looking through for all the gate stuff inside of your craftable window or whatever, which is pretty cool. So yeah, we can actually make some of the big metal walls, which I was thinking might be a good idea for the outside here. This isn't the full size though, so we still need to go out quite a bit. But yeah, I wanted to get the basic. I was going to do the whole thing and then kind of maybe not work in the base at all today, but I decided we might as well just get like the basic area of the base and we can worry about the outside walls a little bit later. It's probably better to actually have a base now. So yeah, there we go. We're doing all that kind of stuff. So I also want to make some vaults. I want to get the vault area kind of set up. And I was thinking for vaults, we could probably run vaults on this right side and then the left side here going all the way down. I want to have enough room for almost everything. So we're going to have a armor vault, a weapon vault, like a metal vault, a crystal vault, an obsidian vault, a wood vault, a stone vault. You know, like vaults for absolutely everything and probably like a random junk vault too. So we're probably looking, I think each of these could probably hold 5, maybe 6 vaults. So maybe around 12 vaults. We're probably not going to be able to make all of that today, but let's see. I want to see what the vaults actually require. So that's that. Actually, do I even know vaults? Let's just go ahead and look this up. Vault. We know. Yes, we do. Okay. So large metal vault to securely store goods. And, you know, we could even make the medium vaults and just have like a crap ton of medium vaults. Okay, so we actually need to make a fabricator as well. I think we need that for the vault. I'm not 100% sure. But let's just go ahead and go in structures. I'm going to go to crafting. We're going to craft a few of these mega grinders. Let's craft 3 of them. Let's see, what are we missing? So we need flint, metal, and stone. We're probably missing stone, to be honest. I don't think I brought that much stone with me, and I've been throwing a lot of stone out. But I figured also, let's just go ahead and grab this third one. We could do one side of this as the smelting, and then one side as like the grinding. So over here, like this side could be smelting, the other side could be grinders, you know, that kind of thing. So let's just go ahead and start placing these guys down. We could do, I'm not really sure, to be honest. We could do, I mean, we could even do like another little thing right here and make this like our little work area or something. That could work. But for now, we could remake them. Actually, I don't think I have enough glass on me, do I? I have some ceilings. I do not have enough walls. I want to make another thing, but we're going to stick this for right now, like right here. I'll keep the other two on me. There we go. So I need to make some spark powder. So we need some flint and some stone. I'm pretty sure I have all of that except for the stone. Let me go ahead and make a fabricator real quick. Okay, so we have enough for a fabricator now. Let's just go ahead and craft this guy. Also, there's the super fabricator, and then there might be another fabricator. I don't know. We have so many mods. I haven't really played all too much with everything yet. But let's go ahead and throw this guy. We're going to throw this guy up there. Let's see. Yeah, let's throw it right here. We want to make sure that this is decently centered. I can't really tell. Here, let's back up. Yes, 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 yes. Okay, so that looks pretty good. Let's rotate it slightly, take another look at it. Okay, so we need to rotate it slightly more. Then that looks decently good. Yeah, I think that looks pretty good. Let's just go ahead and stick it right there. Boom! There we go. So we have the fabricator. It's nice and level with this, which is awesome. Then if we come in here in structures, metal, storage, yeah, we have the vault. So it's 300 metal ingots, 60 cementing paste, 30 oil, and 60 polymer. We can make quite a few vaults, actually. We have a bunch of metal up there, so let me grab all the metal off of Titanus here. Let's go ahead and get on top of this guy. Boom. I've been smelting a little crap ton of metal. I've also been kind of mining a lot of metal as well. Oh, yeah, look at this. Look at this. Yeah, let's go and turn this off. We have a lot of metal. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, okay. So that's 1,400 metal. This should be good. Let's go ahead and drop down. Oh, yeah, and I made the middle of this glass because I thought it would be kind of cool to look down the water. Maybe we could even park some dinos down there and just be able to keep an eye on them or whatever. It might be pretty neat. Let's go and throw all the metal in here, and then I need to grab the cementing paste and then whatever else we actually need to make the vault. So, yeah, there we go. We might be able to completely fill up one side, actually. Cementing paste, oil, and polymer. I'm not sure if we have enough oil, though. Okay, so let's just go ahead and make some of this so we can make 4 vaults. That's a pretty good start. I'm not sure. I think we're missing... Yeah, we're missing polymer, so I need to make some more polymer. Let's go ahead and go back. I kind of forgot what we need to make polymer. Yeah, obsidian. Actually, we have a lot of obsidian now that I think about it. I'm pretty sure we have a crap ton, and we really have no use for obsidian. Yeah, let's just go ahead and grab a bunch of obsidian. We can just go ahead and make the polymer. Yeah, that's all the polymer we have. Yeah, we have a crap ton of obsidian. Let's just go ahead and grab all of it. Yeah, let's grab every single little bit. I think we have even more. Yeah, we have a lot of obsidian. A freaking lot of obsidian. Let's just go ahead and grab all this. There we go. I think today is mostly, we're going to name the sharks, and then I kind of want to go get a Gallimimus, and then I think that's, and we're going to be working on the base today. So if you guys are down for that, then we should get a lot of stuff done today. I think it's going to be pretty sweet. Let's just go ahead and throw all of the obsidian in here. Composition, we will make 120. Now we will be using, I think, a lot of our... cementing paste, but I mean, we can get a lot of cementing paste, so it's not really that big of a deal. So yeah, we have 4 vaults. It's going to take me a while to actually center these guys because I'm pretty OCD when it comes to things like that. So I guess I'm going to pause it. I'm going to work on centering these guys, and then we will be back. Okay, guys, we're back. So I've placed a lot of vaults. Each wall is going to be able to hold a lot of vaults. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then let's see, 8, 9, 10, about 10 per side, maybe 11. But yeah, 10 per side would be pretty good. That'd be 20 freaking vaults. That'd be awesome. So I'm probably just going to be trying to finish this one side for right now, considering we've actually used a lot of our resources. I'm crafting a bunch of polymer right now, so that's one thing we are lacking, so that's pretty good. So let's just go ahead and name these guys. I was thinking, we got a lot of name suggestions, and I really appreciate that, guys. Like, all the support has been absolutely amazing. I love you, and thank you very much. We're going to get on this guy and change name. We're going to name him Solus, which is pretty cool. Solus is the sun, Latin for the sun right here. But the other one we're actually going to name Everest. So let's come over here. And just because I thought it was kind of cool, you know, he's like a mountain megalodon, naming him like mountain or Everest or, you know, something like that. I thought it'd be pretty neat. Let's come over here. Yeah, we're going to name this guy Everest. Come over here, change name. Let's see, Everest. There we go. Also, I forgot to mention, they actually got rid of the Warden armor, but they did all the blueprints for them, so I was able to spawn it back in. Now, the problem was I didn't look between the last episode, so I'm not sure which one I'm actually missing. Which piece I didn't have. I was missing one piece, so if you guys want to remind me which piece, I'll like delete that off camera or whatever. Also, a lot of people was saying with the Dodo Rex here that once you go over 250 stats of any stat on any creature, like once you click more than 250 times, it resets the stat. So I was kind of worried that I didn't think I did for any single stat. So I was kind of worried that I might have. So what I've done is I actually spawned in another Dodo Rex just to test to see like what the stats are. So as you can see, these are the stats. A lot of people thought I went over 250 for health and then 250 for melee damage, which I might have. I'm still not sure, but they did definitely nerf the Dodo Rex hard. If we come here, let's just go ahead and look at this guy. So I did about 200 in health and about 200 in melee damage. So this is what I got. I've already re-logged and done that kind of stuff. And I've done maybe about 50 or, I did around 200 in health and around 200 in melee damage, and I probably did around, 20, 30 in movement speed. Well, let's see. They get 2.5%, so that is, that's about 20. Yeah, that's about 20. About 200 each. So if it does, after 250, if it resets, then I might have done that with this Dodo Rex over here. I'm not 100% sure. But yeah, we did another Dodo Rex here. I just wanted to kind of like test and make sure. But this guy is definitely better than our Dodo Rex over there. And I think our Dodo Rex over there is, 36 levels higher. But that's just base level, so it doesn't really add all that much. But yeah, this Dodo Rex is actually pretty cool. I think I might kill this one over here and then keep the new one that I've done, just because the stats seem to be a little bit more legit. And I've made sure this time not to go over 250. That's pretty much all I've been doing. I haven't actually replaced any of these guys over here yet, so I still need to do all that, but I've been doing a lot of building and stuff off camera. So I guess what we're going to do now is I'm going to take a creature out. We're going to go out and hunt for some creatures and then maybe try to get a Gallimimus or something else that's really cool. I could take Angel out. I thought the dragon would be better because with the dragon, we're able to pick up almost anything, and they've changed it to where... Wyverns or whatever. They've changed it to where their wyverns are actually kind of like the small dragons mod. So you have a normal attack, you have a fire breath with right click. Then you can press shift or control or whatever you use to crouch. I have it on control. I think it's actually normally C or V or something. And you can pick things up. So they're pretty much exactly like small dragons now. So you don't even need small dragons in the mod pack anymore. Actually, what are these guys over here? Let's see. Yeah, I think the dragon's probably going to be my go-to guy now. Let's see. Dire Wolf level 24. And then there was another Dire Wolf over here. Let's see. What is this guy? Is this guy a special guy? No, he's a normal guy. But anyways, there's an elite spider that I haven't actually even seen on camera. I've seen them before in the wild, but I thought it might be... No, passive. 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 Yes. We are going... we're going to try to tame this giant spider right here. Hey, what's up, man? They look pretty cool. Yeah, what's up, bro? Let's see. So he's level 192, which is pretty good. Let's just go ahead. We're going to try to knock him out. There we go. And I killed him. Okay, well, that is... that's awesome. I just straight murdered his face. Hey, here we go. Yeah, Jigginaut source. Okay, lag. I'm going to let you catch up. Yes. Okay, let's see if we can fight this guy. Now, I'm probably not strong enough to take him head on, but we're going to give it a good try. Bro! Hey, what's up, man? You want some of this? Okay, no. Or you can bite me. That's cool as well. Yeah, what's up, man? Oh, he's attacking me. Let's see. Can we take him down? Oh, no. Okay, let's fly away. Wow. Okay. That's definitely not a good idea. Can I back up? I just want to attack you, man. I'm out of stamina. Oh, wow. This is bad. I still need to tame a Giganotosaurus. We're going to try to do that sometime in the future, sometime soon. I think that'd be a good idea. Okay, I got my stamina back, at least most of it back. Let's do some fire breaths. Yeah, maybe we can kill him with fire. I think that'd be a pretty cool idea. Hopefully he can't actually hit me from here. Can you hit me from here? Yes, you can. Dang it. Okay. He is draining the crap out of my stamina. Wow, I don't think I can kill a Giganotosaurus with this dragon at the moment. Maybe if I level him up a little bit, maybe we should go try to find some monkeys or something. That might be a good idea. Oh, look at this. We never actually got that red Carno from like 5 episodes ago, did we? So we don't have a Carno, right? Or do we have a Carno? I'm not 100% sure. But this is a green torpor Carno, so that's actually pretty cool. Maybe let me land. Let me shoot it with a couple arrows. And then we are going to try to get this guy, I guess. Hey, what's up, man? You want some of this? Oh, no, I missed. I totally missed. We're going to totally shoot this guy. Hey, what's up, man? What are you doing? You're just kind of stuck. That's perfectly fine. Just stay stuck. Just continue to be stuck forever. And I guess we'll give it a couple swings to save on arrows. We actually need to find some penguins, probably. Oh, wait. I don't want to kill him. Please don't kill him. Don't kill him. Don't kill him. Don't kill him. Are you going to get knocked out, or are you just going to sit there for a while? He's level 300 and something, so this guy's going to be pretty good, I think. Okay, he's down. He's down. Okay, sweet. So I just wasted an arrow, which is fine. He has 94,000 torpor. This guy's actually going to be pretty good, except for I have no way of freaking taming him. Let's kill something. We need to kill something really fast. We have a little bit of time. Dragon, come here. Oh, wow. Actually, you know, I'm probably better off just finding something. Dragon! I really want this guy. We do not have a Carno yet. I don't think, anyways. Like, I always get confused about one thing, because I've seen so many creatures that I'm not sure. Sometimes I get confused about what I've tamed and what I haven't tamed. Where are the creatures at? Oh, my God. We're not going to get this guy, are we? Oh, there he is. Okay. We'll just do cooked meat. We'll do cooked meat. Oh, I don't have any... Dang it, dude, this guy's stamina sucks. Land. There we go, land. Okay, we're going to get off of him. Let's run over here. How much torpor do you have? You're down to 60,000. Let's come over here. Are you going to eat it? Can you eat it? Yeah, you can eat it. Let's see, what are you... Oh, wow, I don't think that's enough. Okay, so he's eating that. Dang it, I don't have any of my stuff on me. Boom, remote use item. Okay, that's going to halt it there for a second. We need to get some raw meat before he eats all that. Let me find some, like... something to kill, and I'll be back here in a second. Hey, Oviraptor, or whatever you are. Yeah, you're dead. Yep, you're level 128. Actually, we haven't tamed it. Oh, 38 prime meat. Yes. Okay, this is perfect. This is exactly what we wanted. I need to kill some golden dodos for sure, but this does make it a little bit more interesting doing it like this. Let's do this. Remote use item. Give me... Actually, let's put the prime meat on you first. Yes. Yes, we're going to take my food back, and then you should tame really fast. Really fast. Yes. We might ride this guy around. He seems to be pretty cool. Yeah. So name suggestions down below for this guy. Oh, yes, a badass Carno. Awesome. He's level 487, which is pretty good. He has a lot of stamina. He has a decent amount of weight. He has some melee damage, and we can do some movement speed. Yeah, actually, can we craft a Carno thing, or do we need to... Oh, we can. Okay. We need hide fiber, metal, and alpha camouflage potion. What? How do you make an alpha camouflage potion? They changed all this. Alpha... Oh, my God. The things, they're different. Alpha camouflage. Let's see. Alpha... camouflage potion. This potion makes you nearly invisible to alpha creatures when provoked. The effect will vanish. Let's see. Carno, was this badass? No, that's an alpha Carno saddle. Okay, so that's just for alphas. I've learned that regardless. Can we pick this guy up with the dragon, and then we can take him back to base and do this like super quick style? Oh wow, he's pretty big, isn't he? He's almost as big as like a normal T-Rex. Oh, we can! Yes, this is awesome. This is awesome. This is really, really cool. I need to level this dragon, though. That's the first priority, is leveling this dragon. Okay, so I'm back at base. What I want to do is I'm going to drop the Carno here. Yes. We're going to fly over here because I just saw a Megalodon. I think it's a blue Megalodon. So it's a snow Megalodon, which is going to be pretty sweet. I don't know exactly what it is yet, but we're going to find out real quick. And then I guess what I'll do is I'll log in and out and make a saddle for both these guys, and we'll check out the stats. So there it is. I think I just saw it. Boom. Let's drop down right here. A land. There we go. We're going to go in the water. This might be a horrible decision, by the way. But we're going to see if we can draw it up to the shore and maybe shoot it a little bit. It is. Oh, yes. It's a blue Megalodon. That's exactly what we want. It's not exactly what we want, but it's going to make it really good to get around under the water for sure. What's up, bro? You want some of this? Hopefully I don't kill him. Please don't kill him. Please. I'm going to stab you. Yes, we're going to stab. Stab, stab. Stab, stab. You're level 272. I need you. I'm going to shoot you with a bow a few times. Yes, yes, yes. Okay. Oh, I'm freezing to death. Okay, I think we're good. I think we're good. Please don't kill him. Please don't kill him. Maybe I should wait a little bit. Oh, he's down. He's down. Yes, 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 yes. Okay, so do I have... No, no. Shark, shark. Get out of here, shark. Get out of here, shark. Oh, you're dead. Okay, so we have the Megalodon. Yes, 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 yes. This is awesome. We're going to do a little bit of this. Oh, and he has some pretty good stats, too. Yes. This guy's going to be sweet. So he's eating the raw meat. Yes, guys, we have a Megalodon. That is awesome. That is really, really good. I guess what I'm going to do is I'm going to log in and out. We're going to check on the stats. I'm going to make a saddle. Well, I'm going to make a saddle, and then we're going to check on the stats and all this stuff. I think it'll be pretty nice. Okay, we're back. So I have finished the wall of vaults right here, which is pretty good. I'm going to turn you off because you are very loud. So, yeah, we finished one wall of vaults. Let's go and count these guys. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay, so it's definitely... I'm recounting. Yeah, 11. It's 11 vaults per side, so that should be definitely enough storage. So I was able to actually finish this wall and then do a couple right here just to kind of get started. What I did was I based it off the center of this, which is this guy right here. So I guess that means we'll go 5 this way and 5 this way. So yeah, 11. One in the middle, which is pretty cool. So I've logged in and out. We also have a saddle on each of these guys. Now my problem... Oh, okay. It's fixed. I was having a thing when I first tamed this guy. I put a saddle on him. I was riding him around. I was sprint, and it would be like slower than his walking speed right here. It was really weird, but it seems logging in and out has fixed it. Let's go and check his stats. So he has about 8,000 health, 7,000 stamina, 1,000 oxygen, 3,000 weight, 400% melee damage, 100% movement speed. He also has 133,000 torpor. So it looks like the devs have actually increased the torpor of all, like, badass creatures, maybe? Because it didn't feel like I had to spend that many arrows per thing, which I think is actually a good thing. That's actually a pretty good change. We still need to go and kill a bunch of penguins. Someone was telling me in the comments of last video that there's, like, a iceberg or something? I don't know. I'll have to look on the Valhalla, like... thing where it shows where everything is, see where penguins spawn. But yeah, then the shark has 14,000 health, 6,000 stamina, 2,900 weight, 300% melee damage, 100% movement speed. Let's do movement speed. Yeah, 5%. And this guy is going to be pretty fast. Yeah, I think he's going to be like our underwater choice for sure. Either this guy or the frog. The frog's also pretty fast. And he looks the coolest too. I think this guy definitely looks cooler than the other two sharks. We could go check it out. Let's see. Yeah, so we have 3 of the 4 sharks now, which is pretty cool. That's actually my end goal, is to have like one of every type of badass, one of all the elites, and then one of all the ubers. Maybe even 2 of all the ubers, because I would like to breed them and see what the babies look like. So yeah, definitely the blue and red one looks cool. I think the green one also looks really cool as well. Get off of me, rock. So yeah, also we've done a lot of progress in the base today, but I think what I'm gonna do, guys, I'm gonna go and call it here. If you guys enjoyed the video, make sure to go and click the like button. I'd really appreciate it. Help me out tremendously, and I'll see you guys in the next one. This was definitely a very productive day. More productive than most days. My only problem, so far is the dragon. His stamina is absolute crap, or he uses stamina too fast. And it doesn't seem to really be that strong, but I think stamina is the weakest part of the Wyvern, yeah. And this guy's pretty cool. I'm probably going to ride him around now. I'm excited about having a Carno. Now, he isn't the quickest. It might be kind of cool to have, like, a blue Carno, or maybe even a red Carno for damage. That might be pretty cool. I'm actually kind of curious to see how much stats he goes up, but we need a few more. Maybe we'll level him up real quick. Let's kill this Dodo over here. Hey, what's up, Dodo? You going to give me one experience point? There we go. Yes, you have. So we could do movement speed, melee damage, or health. Let's do health. Okay, so he gets a lot of health. That's actually pretty good. Yeah.